Hi, welcome to this series, Azure SQL for Beginners. I'm Anna Hoffman, a data and applied scientist on the Azure SQL team, and I'm joined by Bob Ward.
Thanks, Anna. I'm part of the Azure data team as well. I've worked in SQL Server for, gosh, now, Anna, 26 plus years. Very excited to be with Anna today to talk about, and through this entire series, about Azure SQL.
Awesome. Thanks, Bob. Now, you know, after this series, we're hoping that you'll learn how to translate your existing SQL Server expertise to Azure SQL. And this is going to include Azure SQL Database and Azure SQL Managed Instance. We're hoping that you leave this with a foundational knowledge of what to use when, as well as how to configure, monitor, and troubleshoot what Bob calls the meat and potatoes of SQL Server in Azure. So, Bob, can you tell us a little more about what the meat and potatoes for SQL Server is and why you wanted to focus on that here?
Yeah, Anna, thank you. You know, kind of peel back a little history of our involvement in this together. I'm just coming off the heels of releasing SQL Server 2019, and I was talking to the team about next challenges for me within the team to help customers understand more about what's going on with SQL. And I thought, what better way than to assess Azure SQL from the perspective of a SQL Server expert? And the meat and potatoes of SQL Server has always been security, performance, and availability. And so, not necessarily in that order, it could be in any order, but those are really the meat and potatoes, the core of what the SQL engine does. So I was thinking to myself, why not assess SQL from that perspective? And if you look here at the modules we're going to do in the heart of this, that is exactly what we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about how does Azure SQL compare to SQL Server from the perspective of security, performance, and availability. And then, Anna, I know I talked to you about this assessment thing I'm working on. You're like, hey, Bob, I'm thinking about this Azure SQL for Beginners thing.
Yeah.
And I've got some ideas to wrap this all together. So, you know, you had ideas of how to even expand just those three things into something bigger, right?
Yeah, so we're going to have a lot of resources available for you outside of just these videos. You'll see two links on your screen, and these are kind of your two main resources to go get. So on the right-hand side, you'll see SQL Workshops. That's where you can find our GitHub repository for this workshop, along with other workshops. And this is going to include all the demos you're going to see in the videos, as well as additional content. On the left-hand side, you'll see a link to Azure SQL Fundamentals, which is going to point you to a Microsoft Learn learning path, which we've worked on to bring you all these modules, including a built-in sandbox where you can try the hands-on labs for yourself for free without an Azure subscription. So really, we're trying several different angles to try to get this content to you in a way that you can consume it. And so we hope that you join us and participate in the community as we go through this series. See you in the next video.